Mini mods.
Let you know where the sheets are.
Oh.
Huh?
I can't get the bag. Joey's gonna help me get the right lineups. Joey. I couldn't get the lineup, the list, because my ink cartridges are low.
And row number 7, inside, that'll be the number 5B of Ian Brissette. Against 6 laps will be the distance. Bob Light, heat race action. First race of the night here, first qualifying event for our Bob Light here, the safety officer. Very first time, Tristan.
Because he knows how to get them more than I do. Every time I tried to, it kept going somewhere else.
Mike Mallett giving us a little bit on the replay. He did figure it out. So the instant replay is working. That's kind of a neat little tool that they've added to our program here this evening. Down into turn number 3 and 4, look to field over again. OJ White stepping up to the corner of the glass.
OJ's doing it.
Inside the flag. Dibble into turn number 1 and 2. Check the outside of the racetrack. Mike Mullen to the high
He's
side. He's going to drive to the high side of the speedway. Mike Mullen is going to be your leader down the backstretch. Mullen out of Paris, New York, drives up to the front of the field. He'll come right through the middle of turn number 4. Now lets it drift out against the good down the outside. Outside got tangled up with another car and started rolling off the top side of the racetrack. Scott Sharp makes a long haul down about 2.5 hours down from Messina, New York, to our speedway here in LaFargeville. And looking out the camera, you can see Scott climbing out through the roof of the car, and that's a great sight to see. So Scott Sharp climbs out of the race car, comes out through the roof. They've got flaps on the roof on these things. And he is out of
the car.
Great sight. Got a good shot of it here on the Dirt Track Digest.tv camera looking at the backstretch.
I didn't even see that.
Scott walking right up towards the racetrack.
Yeah, no, I didn't see it.
Not a happy camera. You see the neck brace coming off, but tell you what, the good thing is he was able to walk away. That thing tumbled quite a few times off turn number two. Halfway down the backstretch here, he got upside down. Said, hopefully we're going to get a good look at it here on our third track digest.
It spilled Pepsi all over.
Because every time I tried to put the name in, it would give me somebody else's name. It wouldn't give me the race car driver's name.
Left the backstretch. That's a cornfield out there. When you get out to the other side of the racetrack, then Scott taking a wild tumble into the tall grass. But good look at it from the Dirt Track Digest TV cameras. Good job, Mike, up there on the roof, getting a beautiful shot of that accident down the backstretch.
Good.
So two laps in the book, he said red flag has been displayed to the field. They are stopped all the way around the speedway. Scott obviously getting checked out by our safety crew over there on the backstretch. That's great. Great sight to see him climb out of it and walk away.
Bartlett showing up.
Yeah. One more time, we're going to get a look at it here. They come off turn number two. A couple cars are going to get together. One car, full. That is Tristan Dibble, the 18. Harley Brown got hooked up with the number 61 of Hunter Lott. And they slowed down, and that's what caused Scott Sharp to go to the outside, and he got off the racetrack, and that thing just launched and took off. So good shot at that replay over on the backstretch. Again, we got to thank the great folks from St. Lawrence Radiology in Potsdam, New York, for sponsoring our racing, as they have each and every week that we've been open here at the Can-Am Speedway. St. Lawrence Radiology servicing a lot of areas throughout the North Country and Central New York. They service Messina Hospital, Canton, Potsdam Hospital, Governor Hospital, Oneida Hospital down in Central New York, and Carthage Hospital right here in the North Country. And St. Lawrence Radiology, we said they have stepped up and sponsored every show we have had here on DirtTrackDigest.tv this year. Also, got to thank the good folks. You just got to look at them from the Barnesville Fire Department over here, as they do each and every week, helping us out. Race Service Center, that's Tim Lobdell and Lisa Lobdell, that beautiful record over there on the backstretch, as well as Junior Welland joining us once again here with his flatbed to help keep things moving along. So the field coming around to the front stretch, we'll get them lined up here while they continue to extricate the 16 of Scott Sharp off the backstretch, and then we'll get ready to go right back to a green flag racing action. So one of the neat things we have here at the Can-Am Speedway on Saturday night, go-kart racing right behind us here on the little track. Obviously, we can't have spectators in, so it's kind of an odd deal there, too. You've got parents out there and their crews with their youngsters, and then we've got guys all the way up to the pro classes for the go-kart division.
That door up a little bit?
Right around 100 cars every Friday night here at the Speedway.
Are you hot? Are you okay?
Are
you hot? Are you okay?
It's getting warm again.
Spectators back here for our go-kart racing action as well.
You?
Yeah. Latest update looks like it'll be a couple more weeks before we are allowed to bring spectators back in. But as we know, that could get extended once again, as it has a couple of times already.
Hopefully, we don't know. The sun was hot.
Beating down. That's probably the rest of the country aren't great with the.
Because it was so hot.
Virus is going around, and New York City obviously hit hard. The governor keeps an eye on
my knee is freaking killing me.
With the population, we've been pretty lucky up here in northern New York. Harrison County took a little bit of a hit a couple of weeks ago, but things are evening right back out once again. Hopefully, we'll be able to put this all behind us. Of course, here sitting just a few miles off the Canadian border here in northern New York, we're used to having a lot of spectators from north of the river. A lot of Canadian spectators make their way over. A lot of Canadian racers join us here. Obviously, they can't Speedway. A majority, it seems like, for a long time, our modified track champions in years past have came from north of the border. We've got a lot of the great Canadian drivers that have made the trip down, called the PNA home, and we love to be able to get our Canadian drivers and fans back here once again. We're coming out this week. Our neighboring track is a couple of hours up north of us, Mohawk International Raceway, up in Bogansburg. Also, Heineken Track, very fast race little track down there. They haven't opened up yet this year. Of course, they get a ton of their cars spectators from the other side of the river as well. And just an outreach week, they have officially closed for the season. That's a tough goal as well. The great place up there at the Mohawk International Raceway. They do a great job up there. Good friend of mine.
Another one down the ball. Way over back.
Timmy's getting a little, huh? A little bit of racing announcing on the Canadian side of the river, but Timmy normally comes down to the few shows with me here. Hasn't been able to make the trip down this year, obviously, with the borders being closed. I miss Timmy. I'm pretty sure he's probably watching us tonight. Good buddy of mine. Dad used to race here years ago. Timmy did a little bit of racing himself. He's a radio personality north of the border. And the announcer at, let's see, he's at Mohawk International Raceway.
Works off turn number two.